Hi Angel hier for tableblog.de. I just got the new Kindle here in Germany. It's been available in the US for a couple of weeks, 2 weeks I think, and now we have it in Germany as well. This one here is the first Kindle with the German language and also France and Spain I think, and a couple of other countries. And yeah, let's unbox this new Kindle. It's 99 euros in Germany, in Europe. And you can get it for $79 in the US with the ad-supported version. And yeah, here we have the Kindle ebook reader without the keyboard, the first one without a hardware keyboard. We don't have a touchscreen here, so we have to use the buttons to navigate the on-screen keyboard. But let's take a look inside the box. We've got a USB cable here, a micro USB to USB 2.0. Oh, there is no PCU inside, but you can get something like this, which I would recommend for anyone who has a tablet and a smartphone, or two smartphones, two tablets, or whatever, because you can charge two USB devices with one plug here. I think this is about 20 euros. Yeah, nothing much else here inside. I think behind here, nothing. We've got a manual here on the top. Yeah, manual, warranty and so on. We don't need that right now. We want to have a closer look at the new Kindle. It weighs 170 grams. It's a 6-inch display. We've got 2 gigabytes of storage inside, which is enough for 1400 books. We've got no speakers, so you can't use audiobooks from Audible or so. Yeah, let's go quickly around the device. There's not much. We've got a back button, a button for the keyboard, the joystick-like buttons here with an OK in the middle, a menu, and a home button. Here on the sides, we've got the buttons to turn the pages, nothing on the front and nothing on the back except for the logos. And here we've got the power button and a micro USB port for this cable. Let's turn it on. I already activated it for the German unboxing video and here we are. Let's quickly start a book. That's this one. So you can see page turn. It's gotten a little bit faster because you don't always see this black like this here. Not in every page turn. It's pretty fast right now. Let's go back to the home menu and take out the keyboard. Here we go. So you have to use, like on a PSP, Xbox or so, you have to use this cursor here to select the letters. It actually works pretty good. I mean, you don't want to write a lot on here and you can't write a lot of here. You have to put your Wi-Fi credentials in, and that was pretty fast. I had no problems with that. And maybe you want to use the keyboard to search for a book or something, but you won't do a lot of typing on here. So I think this on-screen keyboard is okay. Of course, not the best solution if you want to use this experimental web browser, but if you want to search for a book or so, I don't think that you want to do a lot of browsing on this device. Yeah, let's close this keyboard here and maybe go to the shop. Yeah, we have to go to the menu. You can activate Wi-Fi, go to the archive, search. Let's go to the shop first. I think everybody who had a Kindle will be familiar with this one here. We can go through the library and buy books on here over Amazon. Let's have a quick size comparison with a 7-inch tablet. We've got the HTC Flyer here. And of course, the HTC Flyer is a lot heavier. It's over 400 grams, I think. This one is 170, so the Kindle ebook reader is of course a lot lighter. And you don't have any mirrors here. You can read in the sunshine without any problems on the Kindle. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Nothing special, nothing that much new here. This is a new Kindle from Amazon, $79 in the US, 99 euros in Europe. And I'm Angel from tabletblog.de.